welcome to our Sangha Day pantomime. This is a tale of Snow White and the five hindrances. A tale that will amaze and delight. A tale of caution. A tale of intrigue. A tale of good versus evil. A tale of longing. A tale that starts, as all good stories start, on a winter's eve many years ago. So I invite you to make yourselves comfortable, forget your worries, and enjoy. It starts with a good queen. A good queen, sewing by the light of a flickering fire, gazing out at snow gently falling. The good queen sighs. And in that sigh is all the longings of her heart. And as she sighs, she pricks her finger. Of crimson blood falls onto the snow-white cloth.
Oh, how I long for a child.
And so it came to pass. The king and queen were blessed with a beautiful daughter. And they called her Snow White. But happy endings were not to follow. The queen passed away and the king remarried. His new wife was beautiful, clever, ambitious. But with a stain of hatred upon her heart. And she hated Snow White with a passion. Because Snow White was beautiful and kind and good. With the wicked queen came her faithful companion, a mirror. A mirror who could only tell the truth. And this is where our story starts.
Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest of us all?
You are the fairest of them all.
And the queen was content, but Snow White was not.
He loves me not. The thing is, I'm lonely. The castle's big and old and dusty. I can be gone for hours, nobody notices and nobody cares. If only I knew what was beyond the castle walls. If only I have some friends, and maybe. I wonder.
And Snow White went where she should not, to the heart of the wicked queen's domain, to her private chamber, to speak to the mirror.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of them all?
Your stepmother holds that title, dear.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, will I meet a prince handsome and tall?
Deep in the forest by the fast-flowing brook, there you will meet him with his long flowing locks.
Ooh, I like that.
And for a while, Snow White was content.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, will the prince love me forever?
The prince loves himself and is adored by Hello Magazine.
Happy.
That is a truth only you can know. If you look into your heart and follow the path of your longing, happiness can be yours.
I was just hoping for a yes answer, actually. Don't you get fed up answering questions all the time?
Do I? Have you any idea how tedious it is answering the same questions day in, day out, year in, year out? Does my bum look big in this? Is my lipstick smudged? Am I the fairest of them all? If only you knew who I was. If only you knew to ask the right questions. The important questions. The questions that lead to the truth. Not the tiny questions with a tiny T for a tiny truth, but the big truth. The exquisite truth, the most universal truth, the
Snow White, where is that pesky child? I'm here, dear stepmother. What are you up to?
Nothing.
We'll go and do it somewhere else. I see very important to attend to. Mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all?
You are the fairest of them all.
Marvellous. Now, where's that clothes catalogue, the latest one?
In the cupboard by the mantelpiece.
And so the long days passed until...
Mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all?
You are lovely, it is true. But Snow White is far lovelier than you.
This cannot be. Where is the vile child?
She sits by the river, singing, a garland of flowers in her lap.
No more river, no more flowers, no more beauty.
And with that, the queen called upon the huntsman.
Yoo, huntsman! Over here, little man. Thank you. Far enough. I want you to go into the forest, find Snow White, and cut her heart out. Are you deaf? I said I want you to go into the forest, find Snow White, and cut out her heart. Or it will be the chop for you too. Did you get that? I made a pun.
Clever as well.
So light.
There are places that you don't go to at night. And the forest is one. Dark it is, with twisted roots and grasping thorns, where paths lead in circles to dead ends or deep rushing water. It is a place that hides those wanting to hide, where the songbird is silent and there are sounds of things that make the blood freeze. So the huntsman took Snow White, but he could not kill her. Left her in the gathering gloom and hastened away. Left her to the strange whisperings and mutterings of unforgotten things.
Tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow. Creeps in this petty pace from day to day until the last syllable. Recorded time. And all our yesterdays are blighted fools the way to dusty death. Art, art, brief candle. Life's but a walking shadow. Away, away you from that there tree.
Nothing scares me. Now what I need is to find somewhere to stay. Let's see. Oh, look over there. Why, it's a lovely stone cottage. Ooh, with a bright green door. Ooh. And the smell of dinner. Ooh. Oh, and a lovely table made for five. Oh, and five comfortable looking beds laid out.
I'm quite tired. I can't just go to sleep.
Dear Yes, it will.
To the floor. Hindrances return to their cottage in the wood.
Oh, I know, it's hard for work we go. With that rebel and a nasty spell, I hope, I hope, I hope, I hope.
Oh! It's pie night tonight. I wonder if Snow White's forgotten.
Well, there's a good chance she might. She doesn't know our ways, and we can't expect her to remember everything.
Well, as long as I don't have to do anything, it's worn out.
But can she even make pastry? I saw her last week. She was slamming it on the table. Makes it tough, you know.
Well, I hope we have gravy and peas. Oh, and those little new potatoes swimming in butter.
But all thoughts of dinner vanished when they saw Snow White on the ground.
Oh, what if she's dead?
Oh. Look at that beautiful comb, all the colours.
Don't touch it, it could be poisonous.
Well, I don't know about that.
For once it may be right, let me do it.
You have to take it out, it's so pretty.
No, let me do it. I'll do everything, don't I?
So ill will gently took the comb from Snow White's hair, and she opened her eyes.
Oh dear. It's a horrible dream. Oh, I was just trying to help the dear old lady, and then suddenly...
And so Snow White promised the five hindrances that she would not leave the cottage grounds and would run and hide if anyone came near. But Snow White was a dream girl. And had many hours to fill. She could sing to the butterflies and however much she tried to coax the small animals to help her with her chores, they never did. Just looked at her with their bright, inquisitive eyes from a distance. And so Snow White would sigh and wonder if this was all that life was about. Then one day...
Buddhist Centre? Is that another word in Prince and Ball?
No, not.
Are you a prince?
No.
He's not, but I am. And I'm free. I can offer you riches and jewels and pretty dresses and good media coverage.
I can't.
What can he offer you?
Well, I can offer you a way to your heart's desire.
Sorry, it's just so unprincely.
Well, you know where you are if you need us.
Need you, pale, pasty man. Someone like me with muscles and fine physique. Someone who can do manly things. Will you be my wench and I'll make you my wife?
Shall we get to know each other first?
But I'm the prince, I'm the real deal.
Well, yes, but I just thought, you know.
Oh, do you need me to woo you?
Woo you?
Very well. Then I'll take you on my fine stallion to the secret plain. And we'll picnic on fine morsels, and I'll tell you how beautiful I am. I mean, how beautiful.
No!
Oh, yes, I'll ask you about yourself, and I'll listen with full attention and empathise in all the right places.
You have a lovely voice.
Many hours later.
Oh, yes, and then I do my weights, and I go running in the forest, and swim in the lake, and then drink fine wines, and eat roast boar, and make merry with my court jesters.
The next day, they hi-hoed their way out of the forest
hi-ho.
To a place.
Hi-ho! It's off to the cafe we go.
The place of the books and the Dana Cafe.
Hi-ho! Hi-ho! It's off to the cafe we go.
But Snow White and Crazy were enchanted.
Oh, look at
the breakfast. Can't have half
breakfasts. Half a breakfast? What's that all about? Is it common half a plate?
Don't be silly, Ilwill. See, people like me who want to fit into that special dress.
Oh, yes. About that.
Who's going to order?
I am. I'm going to have.
Oh, I wonder why it's called Dana.
Oh, I'm glad you asked that. Dana. Generosity.
Oh, I like that. Can I have a refill and one of those peanut butter chocolate brownies, please?
That's what they mean, craving.
Dana is a practical, altruistic aspect of the Bodhisattva's life.
This is the first of the six paramitas.
Or transcendental virtues.
I'm not talking about Gosh, what's a bony sat bird?
A bony sat bird is a being whose life is dedicated to the attainment of enlightenment. But I'm not sure.
Enlightenment is the ultimate awakening. The four shunyatas are traversed.
What's enlightenment? What's shunyata? Gosh.
Dear.
Oh, I suddenly feel all sorts of, lovely. I think I might even like you. I feel awake.
I feel certain. I think.
Yes, but why shunyata?
Shunyata is filling the sublime emptiness with breakfast.
Perhaps you'd like to go to the Buddhist Centre, and then you can ask all the questions you like. Although I think your friends already know.
What we need is breakfast and lots of it.
Deep in Walkley, behind a fine stone wall. is a great stone building topped with a Buddha god. Deep in contemplation, there you will find Snow White, with rosy cheek and petaled lips. There, O Queen, is the fairest of them all.
A Buddhist centre.
And I wondered if you could put up a flyer for us. I'm from the Buddhist Centre in Walkley. Yes. Thank you.
Buddhist Centre in Walkley.
Yeah, I'd be happy. Yoga and Tai Chi and a really great summer fair. Oh, I see you've got quite a lot of stuff about. This mirror, for example.
Stop talking! Are there plants?
Yes, there's plants, and we have beginners, thus people of all ages.
Exactly what do you mean, all ages?
and a really good summer fair.
Take that stuff of Snow White's from the corner there. Buddhist centre. Buddhist centre. So what exactly is a Buddhist? Oh, them. Oh. I saw a Buddhist once at the garden centre. Big, fat, fairly disgusting little man. Buddhists. Oh. Them. Oh, yes. Sit around contemplating their navels all day, yeah. Drinking endless cups of herbal tea. Is it tea without milk? And that endless dreary chanting. And so self-absorbed, unlike wife. Well, I have to think about this Buddhist centre. Perhaps I could go along. I could disguise myself as an ordinary person. It's hard to disguise such a fierce beauty as mine.
And so the Queen got to thinking and thinking.
So I could disguise myself like the innocent flower, but be the serpent underneath.
And this is Sloth, and Craving, and Ill Will. She can be a little bit grumpy.
Those names sound familiar.
Yes, very familiar.
I can see why you want to come here. Must be a terrible hindrance to have names like that. I expect you want to change.
Oh yes, I like to change. I change 3 times every day and 5 at a weekend.
Oh dear, I only change once a week.
Oh, why should we change? Nobody said anything about changing. I have changed.
And I have changed before.
Yes, like whether peep and mustard go together.
Oh, why we should make our beds?
Yeah, or clean the windows, or lock the door when we've gone out.
Oh, why people are so annoying.
I'm not sure this is the right kind of place for those sort of questions.
You are quite right.
Those aren't important questions.
Truthful speech is important.
And wisdom and knowledge of things that are important. I know the Dharma.
I know the Dharma too.
Well, I can say Pratichasamutpada.
Well, I can say Ratnaguna Samchagata.
Well, from the Dharmapada off by heart.
Well, I can quote from the Bodhicharyamatara.
Really? I'm listening.
You wouldn't understand.
How dare you, you Mahayanist?
you Theravadinist?
Isn't it a little less complicated? It's just, I was reading my book about the 5 precepts and I just thought...
Oh, the 5 precepts, yes, that's for beginners. But if you just started out, it's not... You can't expect you to know the depths, the intricacies, and the knowledge.
No, you can't, but we're always told that we have to work with the level that is before us.
Yes, the Buddha said that.
Skillful means.
And if you are simple,
then we must come down to your level.
Not being very rude.
No, skillful.
Generous even.
That is one of the precepts.
And I am very generous.
I'm even more generous.
I gave a homeless person some money today on the street.
Well, I gave a poor person on the street my jacket.
Well, I gave them my car.
No, you didn't.
No, that's right, I didn't. I don't have a car. I think about the environment.
I think about it too.
Yes, but you have a car.
Well, yes. But I drive people, important people. I drove Padma Vajra.
Also, where to?
To an important place. And we spoke.
Oh dear, this is awful. I think we should leave.
Right, it's you two. So you're doing the beginner's course, I see. Right, good. So you'll be nice and friendly.
Yes.
Yes. Remember our little rule? Yes, if we take a particular shine to somebody, that we wait till the course is finished. Well, thank you very much. Welcome to the beginner's course. Welcome. We're going to do a meditation class. So if you'd like to get yourself a stool or a chair or a cushion, then we'll begin. And oh, welcome. Welcome. You want all kinds of beings to absorb.
I think I'll take all 3.
Yeah. Chair though. What if I fall off it? Maybe a cushion.
Maybe
I won't be able to get up. That's a bit of a
transfer. Don't be silly, it's just to be quiet. I'm sitting around, this is just my thing. I think I want a cushion and some blankets and that.
Oh, my lovely experiences, and afterwards I can put it on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Super Chat, and Tinder. hashtag super spiritual, hashtag cross leg not kneeling, hashtag full lotus position, hashtag not doing it for followers, hashtag for the benefit of all beings. Push them all in those chairs.
Well, if you'll shut you all up for a while, it's a chair for me.
And the order member taught them the mindfulness of breathing.
Oh, this is lovely. The feel of the chair, the smell of incense.
Not very mystic, just counting, is it? One, two, three. Oh, you don't meditate lying down.
Oh, director and narrator.